Fred Hampton got assassinated, just to clarify further. What y'all gave birth is the chairman mixed with Jeff Ford. Big step on the jet with my legs crossed. Black stones on my neck, y'all can't kill Christ. Black Messiah is what I feel like. Shit ain't gon' stop, cause y'all spill blood. We gon' turn up even more since y'all killed God.
This is what it feels like.
I believe I'm gonna die, no code.
It is, you know it is, your boy Joe the Mac.
Juice Osama. This is Love the Lord, Jesus podcast. We got a very, very special guest. I'm gonna let him introduce himself.
Mike Brown saying, what's up, y'all?
I know what it is. Had to get Big Dog here. First question we ask everybody. If you had to choose between love or loyalty, what would you pick?
Loyalty.
Why?
You gotta have you gotta be around people, man. You trust, bro. You know? Hey. Love don't last. Loyalty, bro. You know, it means everything, man. You know, shit. You can move along. You can move a long way with loyalty, brother.
You got any like example where you had to choose between those two that ever happened in your life before?
Yeah, man. You know, childhood friend, man. You know, things changed in my life. You started doing some foul stuff, man. You know, I had to cross out the love part. You know what I'm saying? He wasn't showing no loyalty. You know, he's doing a lot of backstabbing. You know, using my name, man, getting cooch. Use my name and do all type of stuff, man. You know, it was foul. You know, so I had to cross out that love on there, man. And I'm like, with no truth in that.
Like, when that incident happened, did you ever approach him like, hey, bro?
Yeah, you know. You know. You know, but it's crazy, you know, after all that time and all them years, come to find out that same look I never paid attention to. I should have been paying attention to over the years. Really, I caught on to.
Too late.
Yeah, it was too late. So I had to go on, you know, counsel it.
That's hard, though. Like I say, everybody grow up with situations like that.
Yeah.
Like I said, we, and like I say, from almost all of us from around the same area.
Yeah.
Normandy, Pine Line, like all of us.
Yeah.
Well, I said, like, even before everything happened, I knew who you were.
Yeah.
I say you legit right up the street, on the other side.
You right.
We over at the one, like, so I'm like, yeah, you know, St. Louis, man, that area is so small. So, like I say, to see everything now, to turn your story, what you just said, I'm just thinking, like, damn.
Which one is it?
Man.
Man. I know who you know. Which one was it?
Man, nah, yeah, man, because, man, look, like, I'll tell you, I mean, shit, starting in 2000, I probably said 2007.
Mm.
That's when it started hitting, like, the back door stuff over there.
Yeah, man.
Started hitting crazy over there. Where I told you, we started with him, brother.
Yeah.
I'm talking about that shit. Like, right after that, just, he got real reckless out there. Yeah. Like, real reckless.
You think he moved like that because he was jealous or anything like that?
Yeah. That, you know, he was the pretty boy, man. You know what I'm saying? So, it's like, what you jealous of me for? You get them all, you know what I'm saying? You get what you want, you know, but, you know, definitely after that turn with Mike, and I guess it seemed like in his eye, the attention changed towards me. But I had to let him know, dude, I lost. This ain't no fame, nigga. You know what I'm saying? What you want, man? But I guess the attention, the people were coming to me, you know, because of what had happened. I don't think the guy liked it. You know what I'm saying? And it's weird, man. You come to find out, man, there's a lot of people that's upset that happened. You know what I'm saying? It's like, damn, did you want that to happen to you? You know what I'm saying? I don't wish this on nobody. Like, what's the problem? You know? So it's just weird, man.
And like I said, right now, it's going on, what, 9 years, right?
Yeah.
Like I said, like we had episodes, and I always tell people down in St. Louis, the thing I feel like most of us have in common is pain.
Yeah.
Pain, yeah. Like when it come down, like you said, you lost your son. Like that, we both got kids.
That's
like,
the world.
In front of the world. Like we seen what happened with the situation, but now to the point, nobody forgot about it. Mm-hmm. But to the point, like nobody's legit still talking. Like, you know, it's like people still moving on. But like I said, you being a parent.
Yeah,
so you go through this pain feeling every day.
It's a life sentence, brother.
That's why I tell people, like I said, I lost my brother. Now I got homeboys that lost their brothers, they moms, everything. They're trying to talk to them. I tell them the same shit. I'm like, man, look, I can tell you what I've been through.
Yeah.
You're going to wake up one morning, you just get a memory, you're going to bust out laughing.
Yeah.
Next memory, you damn near want to just bust out crying. Like, it's legit. Like, and it's not a thing that lasts a month or a week. Yeah. This shit lasts forever. Like you said, man, 9 years. It lasts forever. Yeah. I'm like, just to see you go through that shit, like, and still be here strong. Like I tell people, man, me myself, like I say, lost my brother. I wanted to crash the fuck out. I'm not gonna lie, I wanted to crash out. Losing the son, like I say, I got two boys. Man, look, hey, I don't know what the, like I say, the strongest thing you can do is wake up every day and live and continue to thrive. That's the strongest thing I think as a black man, especially you, I'm talking about you right now, that you can do. You doing this shit, like, fuck the haters. Like I said, the niggas that feel some way about, man, look,
right.
A lot of jealousy and all this envy they be having towards you. Like, you got to wake up every day on that. You ain't got your boy no more.
Yeah.
I never lost a brother or a son or like that. I don't know how I feel.
Yeah.
And can't nobody say I agree with you because they don't know the pain you go through with it.
Right.
But you got to be here for his legacy now.
Got to.
Got to be here for his legacy now.
Got to. It was hard though, bro. You know, hey, man, if I ain't had no praying wife and mother, man, I'll be honest, if I ain't had no wife, I probably would have crashed. You know what I'm saying? To be honest, but I really didn't want to take it out on the whole. I wanted him. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, by a person feeling like they did the right thing at the point, at that time that happened with Mike, I feel like, you know, I don't know if y'all seen the interview, he did live with the, you know, he feel like even if there was a white person, he would have did it. Or whatever, but he feel like he did the right thing at that moment. You feel like you did the right thing at that moment while you're hiding.
Fair.
Yeah, he's fair. You feel like you did the right thing. What you scared of?
I mean, I don't agree with what he did. Like, it's definitely fucked up. He was intimidated by Mike Brown's size. That's what it was. He was intimidated by this big black guy. And that's why he did, I'm sure. That nigga ain't did the right thing. Like, I don't agree with it. It's fucked up.
Nah, you know, it's fucked up. But that's just what he wanted to tell the world, that he did the right thing at that time. You know,
got to save money.
I'm going to say, so with all that.
That's that blue coat. Y'all already know how he done
it.
I'm saying, so with all of that, it's like, say, like, the strength, like you say, you doing this shit, you still thriving for the legacy of your son.
Got to.
So when it comes to it, like I said, we seen everything that happened beginning years ago, like I said, 9 years ago. The point now, shit, you heard it.
Yeah.
People see you in the city. Everybody know exactly who you is.
Yeah.
Everybody know who you is. To the point, like, now, like, just every day, waking up every day, like, what is your next steps? Like, what is that situation change for you? Not in, like, to say, because we know the negative part. We know the fucked up part.
Right.
Just now, like, what do you do now? So I guess it's, like, to change, I don't want to say change the narrative, but just in a positive way, what did it change for you?
Well, I have a foundation. It's called the Michael Brown Senior Chosen for Change Foundation. We had one before. It was the Mike Brown, but it had expired, you know, through the years because we couldn't focus on that. We had somebody else running, and you know how they go. When you got somebody else running, they ain't paying attention to it like they need to. So we ran into rebranding right now. So I do a father's retreat every year, man. The last week of June, man, I take local fathers and national fathers on a retreat. We go out for some healing, some pampering, you know, get out of our city, you know, and get a chance to bond with each other, man. You know, a lot of these brothers ain't never got a chance to cry, you know, even get a chance to really express themselves because, you know, the mental of the black man is supposed to not even be able to show no type of emotions, right? So we wanna break that. You know what I'm saying? This is where you could come and express yourself. I don't care if it's, even if your child has passed away from cancer. Like, some of these fathers have different situations. You know what I'm saying? It's not just police brutality, it's community violence. You know what I'm saying? So, however these fathers need help, man, I got my door open for them, man. So, that's what I do every year. I have a call for them every morning. We greet each other. Good morning, brother. You know what I'm saying? That kind of give brother a good time, a chance to wake up, even after a bad dream or just waking up mad, get a chance to get some type of console from another brother to understand how you feel, you know, and get that push for the day. You know what I'm saying? I got a entity called SWAT. It's a sister with a, what is it? It's new. Sisters with a Taz. It was Sisters with a Perp. Yeah. So, like I said, we rebrand stuff. So, Sisters with a Taz, right? So, that's Mike's sisters. That's their program. You know, they go around, you know, and talk to young ladies, you know. We're trying to get them to Africa. They want to try to help these young ladies make, like, you know, pads, you know, from scratch. You know, these other countries, you know, they get laughed at, they get talked about for things like that they don't have. So they want to go over there and kind of teach them, you know, little things, you know. I have an entity called Mothers of an Angel. So I have these mothers kind of come in and they run their own show. I sit back and we listen, support a, and my wife came up with it, you know, because the ladies was like, well, y'all doing stuff for the men. What about some of the women? So we let them run it, you know. I have a therapist come in, you know, and, you know, get them the tools that they need, you know. So, you know, I'm just working, man. Right now I got a summer camp going on. I hurt my shoulder last week, man, playing kickball. These kids, man, terrible, man, with these guys. But they get you. But, you know, just keeping it moving, man. You know, I'm not sitting still, you know. I'm just trying to keep it going and keeping the legacy of Mike Brown Jr. alive, you know.
And you just said something I want to touch on because, like I said, I didn't believe it myself. You said therapy. Did you go to therapy to help you out with everything?
Eventually.
Because I didn't believe it. Like, and still now, I'm still kind of on the fence about it. Mm-hmm. My man said was like, I can't go talk to somebody that never been through the stuff that I've been through.
Mm-hmm.
I know that whatever white, black person ain't been through the shit that I've been through, mm-hmm. he can't tell me how it feels to legit see my partner I've been growing up with my whole life.
Mm-hmm.
Dad this week, next week my cousin, next week my other homeboy. Like, he can't talk to me about that. Like, talk to my homeboys. To me, this podcast, look, he is my therapy.
Mm-hmm.
But talk to them, they was the ones where they was like, man, shit, no, you probably still need to go to therapists, like a real therapist, and they not supposed to be there to talk to you.
Nah.
They basically there to listen. Mm-hmm. Like, with that, I still feel like at the same time, shit, I would do this with somebody that I know and trust. But they tell them that's the wrong mindset.
Find somebody your color, though, for one. You know, I'm going to be honest, man. I'm not being a racist on her. But what I'm saying is somebody your color has an idea of something that you done went through, bro. You know what I'm saying? Even if it's their mother, their father, their brother, you know, they can kind of relate, you know. It's kind of hard to talk to somebody that don't understand a black man's struggle.
You know what I'm saying?
So just think about that.
I had this conversation. I tell you, like, we play flag football.
Mm.
Out to the football field, I don't know what, roughly, what, 500 dudes?
On Sundays.
So, out there, I'm talking about being on these dudes for years playing football. Just talking to them about, like I say, shit like this.
Mm.
Talk to a guy, my homeboy Shaq, lost his brother. Like, you should see him. Like, you see the shit that he going through battling. And, like, we had a conversation, but I'm still not to the point where I'm like, man, go to therapy. Man, you hurt. I'm just going to listen to him, whatever he's saying. Like, man, I feel the same way, but my situation, it was like this.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, to me, like, that's what I thought worked for me.
Mm-hmm.
But like I say, still talking to somebody that been through therapy and been through therapists and all that, he like, nah, you still need to go here, like, because he might see something I'm not seeing
right
myself. Of course. Like, I feel like I'm okay. Like, I can do better, but
of course.
I feel like I'm cool.
Tell your bro, we go therapy together.
I feel like you need to. Female told me that before. She's like, man, look, you might not think, but nigga, you are hurt. Like, you might not think. I'm like, man, I'm cool. I'm straight. She's like, nah, you really do need to go to therapy. I'm like, nah, I talk to my people. I do this, like I said, I got certain people, like I told him, where certain situations I know where I can call. My big brother, talk to him about this. Got a cousin I can call, talk to him about this thing. But they was like, that's still not the same thing. And I'm like, you been through shit. The worst pain you about can be, go through. And you said the therapist helped you.
Yeah.
But how long, like, was that just an instant, like, man, let me see if this can work for me? Or, like I say, your wife had to get you to go through there. Like, what? Like, it's a step. It's something that pushed you to go through that.
I was almost a mission to damn to explode, bro. So I had to, thinking about this guy every day, man, damn, it killed me, you know? So I had to find some type of release, you know, because, like I say, you know, you go through the trauma, and you go through the mad and the hate, and guess who's paying for it? Your body. My heart don't beat the same from being angry so long.
Stress.
Blood pressure to the roof, you know. So I had to get all that stuff in place. So I had to mentally tell myself, man, that I have to forgive myself for the things that it's feeling. You know, I can't never forgive this guy for doing that to him. But I have to find some type of peace and balance. So I don't kill myself. Shit. He can't get two wins. You know what I'm saying? He'll get a win that he don't even know he got.
That's real.
You know what I'm saying? So I had to get myself together, man. So, you know, it came from you know, people seeing it, like you say, people seeing stuff that you think, you're like, I'm cool, I'm moving around this now, I'm cool. You're lying, bro. You're lying, man, eats you up too, you know? Shit. That's all we know, is to just keep it moving. You know what I'm saying?
That's why we used to retreat. I'm, you know, man, I'm thinking about the retreat thing, like you said, like you go out there, you do it, what, every year?
Yeah, every year, bro.
Every year, retreat, yeah. Just a man to go out there, like I say, to the point where, shit, that's something, like I said, I didn't know about that. My cousin told me about it, like I said, when we had you coming up here, to the point somebody thought, I'm going to the football field with next Sunday. Mm-hmm. And I'm talking to, like, because so many dudes there in St. Louis, like, when I tell you, pain, hurt, that's the most common thing we have down to the point is normal.
Yeah.
Shit is normalized, but, like, I can walk outside this door, see a dead body laying right there, I'm like, damn, that's fucked up, and keep going, walk my day. And that's it shouldn't be like that.
Shit.
So, like I said, I think we most definitely need that, like, most definitely need that.
You got a retreat coming up in a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
Like, where are y'all going? Like, what's on the agenda?
So, this year, I want to do this to the podcast.
You want to give out too much information?
So, we got an injured father. So, we're going to pop up on him. Well, we was going to do Essence this year. It would have been the first year black men would have been on stage together, man. You know, every year they have the black mothers, you know, they done lost their loved ones on stage. We was going to do that, but one of my fathers got injured riding four-wheeler. Cracked some things, man. So I had to change some things. So all of my fathers, we're going to pop up on him. I'm going to see him crying the snotty nose once he see all us pop up on him, because we told him we ain't doing that this year. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, we have to look out for each other, man. When somebody going through something, man, we still got to pull up, you know, and show them love. But, yeah, it'll be Louisville. This is one of my brothers, Cortez Rice. Lost his son last year in a school shooting. He is Bianca's. They're about to get married, which is Brianna Taylor's auntie. So this is how deep this go. You know what I'm saying? So I'm connected with these families. For real, man, through this struggle. So, yeah, we're going to pop up on him, though.
So, like, how would somebody go about joining? Joining the program.
Yeah. Oh, so, but actually this program is, you can call 314-384-6332. We have like a small questionnaire because we done had an issue a couple of years back. One of my fathers didn't know he had some serious issues, mental issues going on. Didn't know he was taking medication, man. Didn't know he was schizophrenic and some other things, you know. And so we do like a little survey, man. Now, man. Sure, you know, it's not a problem if you have those issues. We just need to know how to deal with you. Yeah. You know, see, we didn't know that, and it was all surprising. And we just don't want that to happen again. We don't want these fathers banging it out. You know what I'm saying? No, we got to keep. We are here for one reason only, is to bind it here as much as we can.
Have you ever thought about, you know, incorporating counseling with your programs?
I do. I have we do a cookies and combo every month. It's the women and the men. So it's a therapy session. So we have when our therapists come in, and we'll let her run the room. I got some people that on my team, You know, we do like little activities and stuff like that. We get it out of them. The main thing is keeping some of these people that are long-winded, and we have these newcomers come in and they don't have a chance to have a voice. So we try to figure out how we're gonna do these sessions. Like, we're gonna let the long-winded people go first, or let the people that ain't had a chance go first, you know. But sometimes we have to break the ice because there's some of them ain't really ready to even see and express themselves.
I remember I said something. It wasn't like therapy. It was a sense of like just dealing with people out here, different females or whatever. I just always say like, I feel like they should do like a mandatory class every month for dudes and females. To the point, I'm talking about just fathers and mothers. To the point, you go here, you just listen to people talk. You talk if you want to, but you listen to another mother explain her situation.
Yeah.
Listen to another father. Like, everybody think we in the worst situation. I got the worst baby mamas on her. Crazy for somebody that
worse off.
I ain't gonna say worse off, but just know everybody deal with what they deal with. I feel like people don't understand what they got until you put everybody in the room. You listen to this person's story, like, hold up. In my life, they like, hey, I'm most definitely can do better. I can switch it up. Like, that's something that really do need to happen. It need to be a mandatory, I don't want to say the word therapy, like, it needs to be a mandatory sit down. I'm gonna say
right.
A mandatory sit down. Like, one of the things you said, I caught on when you first came in, you said you would have basically crashed out if it wasn't for your marriage, your wife.
Mm-hmm.
And we, like I said, we always talk about this stuff on the show where I'd be like, unconditional love. Mm-hmm. Like, my thing, I used to say unconditional, I still believe unconditional love is only the love you can get from, I'm going to say, your kids.
Yeah.
Sometimes your parents.
Yeah.
Where you don't got to really give nothing, like, they loving you from the jump. I always say that because it's to the point where you have a baby, the 1-2 minutes of holding their child, you love them instantly.
Love them.
Like they don't have to do nothing, just instantly love them. So I'm like, in a relationship, I always say I don't think that was a realistic thing.
Mm-hmm.
But when I talk to older guys, people that have been married for 20 to 50 years to 5 years, mm-hmm. depending on, like I say, each is on, everybody got their story. And like you said, you wouldn't have been out of here without your wife.
Yeah.
So that's a strong, like,
she reminded me that it wasn't just Mike, you know. Mike had other siblings, you know what I'm saying? So it's key things that she said to make me like, shit, I don't want to be selfish in this situation. You know what I'm saying? And then I end up going through a situation with my kids, you know, fighting for Mike and putting so much in it. And here go the kids like, hey, we still here, we over here. You didn't forget about us, right? I'm like, God, man. So I have to make time and still do push the movement, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, they definitely get me in order, you know. So you know, I got 20-year-olds, you know, and little ones, you know, so yeah, they ain't got no filter. So
you said earlier you said you had to forgive yourself before you were one cast. What did you have to forgive yourself for?
Well, definitely for all the anger. For beating myself up so much, I vowed to protect Mike ever since he came out the womb. You know, the blame game. You know, damn, if I had did this, maybe this one. Shit, was it my past that caught up with me? It's so much, man, that you go through, and I can't explain it. And I pray to God that y'all don't have to live it, bro.
I understand.
You know, but what I'm getting at, it's a beat down on yourself, and then after that beat down. Now it's pointing the finger. We all know who did it. But I'm beating myself up because it happened. You know what I'm saying? So it's a manly thing, man. Just the protective part, you know. And when you feel like you didn't do your best at that, which was out of your control, you still fought yourself for it.
Well, I said, I understand. Like I say, my situation, I always say, man, if I was there, I swear this wouldn't happen to my brother. If I was there, like, I was just over in the area earlier that day. It was too cold. Like, man, I'm about to go home. It's too cold to be over there. And I left. My man said, I tell myself all the time, man, I would have just stayed over there chilling for a good 30 minutes. My brother would have came in, and none of this would have happened. If it would have happened, he would have been all right. I guarantee he would have been cool. That was always my mindset. So, like I say, I know how you feeling with some of this shit, because to the point where, man, I blame everybody that was around. Like, every single body that was around. If it was eight of them there, only one person did it, all 80 hours done. Like I said, everybody had a point to, like, everybody did something where y'all didn't stop it. To me, that was wrong. So I understand what you're going through. Like I said, that shit, like you said, wear on your body, wear, man, your mental. Like, man, I'm talking about, I had, like I say, days waking up where it's like, man, shit, that's why I can't listen to rap music like that. Yeah. My man, so I wake up and I hear a song, it's like an activation, but like, come on, let's go. My man said, now it's to the point, like I say, talking to shit, really this right here. Because now it's to the point where, like I said, I ain't gonna never stop forget or forget anything. And I'm not gonna say it's I forgave the people or the person that did everything. Yeah, shit. It's life. That's how I look at it. Like, man, it's fucked up. If I can change it, I will. If I can do anything, like you said, if I can legit put myself in them shoes, well, shit.
That's part of healing.
Just basically, with me just trying to find some peace with myself. That's it. You could be mad, man. I don't want to drop dead from being so mad. You know, like, shit. You know, I know we have no control over our emotions when things like that happen to us, man. But sometimes some people have to grab hold to it if you got other people that depend on you. You know, so I don't want to leave though, man, being selfish, man. At the end of the day, man. You know, the fact that I got left to it, now they still mad at me. I didn't do what I was supposed to do as far as being still around. So, you know, it go deep, bro. You know, that's just my philosophy. I ain't saying it's the truth. That's just how I feel.
I feel like you need to express all of them emotions to fully get it out.
Yeah.
I feel like you just, like, don't bottle up, like, man, and hold it in.
Yeah.
No, I feel like you need to express every emotion that comes to you when it comes to you to fully get that shit out your system.
That too.
It's a lot,
bro. That's why I say, like, oh shit, like I said, that shit just, that's different because the world seen it. Like, the world. Like I say, you got people that don't understand, like you said, your first situation, and a nigga basically looking at you because you, I guess, I don't want to say involved with different people now, but a bunch of people coming to the city and making sure they rub elbows, you know, make sure they bump into you now.
Mm-hmm.
You got niggas out here that thinking, like, man, fuck, I want to be like that. Like, losers. It don't make sense.
And that's just the beginning. They're just some of them, bro. You know, I used to get hate mail and some more stuff, man. 6-1 mother house and prime line and man, people riding past. Man, we went through it, bro. You know, I had to clear my stuff up, man. I started buying everything that was in the gun store. You know, even the little ones know how to shoot pistols. Hey, the whole family ready. You know, it's crazy though, bro. Just we got violated, but now we the target. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's crazy, bro.
But you know, like the city showed their true face with this situation.
That is a reason.
What our address was at Craigslist for a minute by the white boys. They was, can't say that. But yeah, it is what it is, though. You know, growing up, I knew it was a lie, bro. But after that boy got killed, did like that, man, and started really paying attention, shipping in our face the whole time, man. We call ourselves the enemy, bro. We got a bigger enemy, bro. We fighting the wrong wars. Man. You know what I'm saying? It's
man. Saying, we didn't think
my like mind that. Is wide open, that bro.
So racism in St. Louis,
you talk about racism in Missouri.
We all have masks. Like, man, only racism shit we get down here is if you go to a store, a white man might follow you around the store. Like, with that situation, it's legit. People pulled out, they show their true colors.
They're not behind the computer no more, bro.
They just need a reason. They just need a reason.
They out here now, bro. That's what I'm saying. Man, they'll send your own kind for you. You know, it's crazy, man.
I heard about a situation happening like that to,
Situations like that been happening forever.
Yeah, that's
Ray Hampton. Yep.
You gonna be here. He my keynote speaker in my black bar.
Ray Hampton Jr.
Yeah, I got him coming down here. He in the city.
Last year I had
David Banner keynote speaker for my it was the Masquerade edition last year. So I do this big fundraising award, big conference, you know. Last year, I gave awards out to the front lines, all the people that stood up for Mike back in 2014. spent the night, got in the police face. All the protesters, you know, they're still alive. Except, you know, we honored some stuff during SEALs and Skeeter. But everybody else, I gave them awards, you know. And they had cocktails, you know, time to meet and greet. Just like a regular, you know, event, you know. And I had a keynote speaker, which was David Banner last year. And it was a nice turnout. I had a pit. We had a paintings. People could purchase paint, be it on paintings and stuff like that. It was a nice event.
Like
we
a did. Gala.
Yeah, it was a gala. At the Marriott across the street from the airport last year. You know, around the same time. This one actually will be on August 9th this year. You know, so I'm gonna do the 4.5 hours that I do with the 4.5 minutes out there. You know. Of silent in Canfield, and I got some families that's gonna come in, you know, and do the celebration or memoration of Mike Brown's life and keynote speakers and stuff like that. And then that night, I had a black ball.
They doing all that at Canfield first?
Yeah, they be at Canfield first. So that'll start. That will be at 11:59. For the 4.5 hours, the moment of silence and stuff like that, and release some doves and stuff, and we leave and we let them go and finish protesting or whatever they do. And I'm gonna get ready for this black ball because you know, this gonna be, yeah. And this year I'm honoring teachers, educators. You know what I'm saying? So this gonna be, see, gonna be dope, man.
See, I was say my bro a teacher would. Not like that. He a dance teacher.
This guy.
Yeah,
a teacher is a teacher, bro.
He's stripped.
He's
going to
get intimidated. That man, you might not be about him.
That's okay.
Yeah, bro. You know, you don't want the kids learning this stuff.
Dang,
you don't want them learning that, man.
Hustle is a hustle.
Man, if that's what you did in the past, I ain't judging you, man.
Nothing, man. Nah, but nah, I like that. Ain't like you say Fred Hampton Jr. coming down the top. Yeah. That's why when you said what you said, like, man, they had your own people doing this stuff.
Yeah, man.
They been doing that for years, like forever.
So are you selling tickets to the black ball? Like,
yeah.
Where can they purchase them, man?
So you go order BSP on the Eventbrite. We will have this key code. We have it posted. We're going to have it on our foundation page. So you go to the foundation page and get it. So I forgot which live I could pull it up. I think we just talked.
I know.
You know
what
I'm saying? But we're like, yeah.
Record everything.
So, yeah. So this will be the second annual Black Ball. This year. Educate. I wanted to do first responders, but you know what they, when you say first responders, you know what that means.
Yeah.
I'm like, I can't just do firemen. So we got to figure out something else, man.
Let me ask you a question about that, because with that happening too, like, what did your man say? Because, like I said, we grew up, or you already know they tell him when he was young, like, man, stay away from police.
Mm-hmm.
You know what the police on. Mm-hmm. But with that thing that happened to you, that situation, you look at our police, like,
same.
Y'all fucked up.
I look at my same. Miss, I don't know if you remember, we just called Monkey Man.
Yeah, Buchanan.
So, Buchanan, yeah. Right? So, Buchanan, I'm going to keep it 100. You know, we're going to talk, hey, he don't mind hearing his name. It's high school name. but you know, he kind of tried to rub elbows and stuff like that and try to get me into the different things that be going on. He always been okay, you know. He wasn't Mr. Haynes, you know. If you remember him, you know, he didn't want to put me out of school yet, but whatever. But he's been doing a lot of things and been trying to rub elbows with me and do some back to schools and stuff like that. But yeah, it's just, yeah, when I see it's the uniform though, bro. I don't even think it's the actual person, it's the uniform that make you cringe. It's the lights behind your car when they come on. You don't know what they're going to do. You know what I'm saying? But with me, you know, it's just like, I don't know, man. They killed my son, bro. I look at it like they. So, when I see him, man, I depends on how I feel. I might mug their ass. You know, I don't know, man. You know, I'm getting a little better. But, I don't trip off them. I walk past them like they not even that, man. Like, you know, they don't bother me, man. You know?
It's so fucked up, but it's with black people, because we have to have this talk with our kids. Little police pull you over.
Yeah.
Make sure you see your hands. Make sure you ain't on no bullshit.
See, the only thing about that is, I'm going to be real. Have you ever had somebody give you that talk?
No.
I never got that talk. But it's like when it comes down to that's the stuff that we see on, I want to say television, or they tell us, like, yeah, had this talk. But my thing, like, some stuff is common sense a lot of times. Yeah. It's depending on they can feel whatever way they feel. If they feel fucked up, there's nothing that talk can do to save your life. Like I say, I seen this dude sitting behind this camera, mm-hmm. most reckless talking to the police mm-hmm. thing ever, like, ever. Mm-hmm. Or you get flagged, you know you got one. I'm like, man, chill out. Like, everybody tell me, man, chill out.
Mm-hmm.
Non-stop. Yeah.
I think he just know his rights, bro. You know, even though he probably wrong, he still know his rights. And his rights still stand. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man. My kids, right? So, they are very traumatized by this situation. Bro. I try to be on my best behavior if they're in the car with me, if something like that happened. We had something like that happen a few years ago. I think we was going to Memphis when we got flagged. Smoking tobacco eating motherfucker pulled us over, right? So, she was driving. I'm on the passenger side. He talking weird at first. She talked to him cool, you know. He kind of balanced his voice down. And took a look in the back. They all looking. I'm like, I hope he don't do nothing, because this finna be bad. Because everywhere, I don't care where I'm going, I'm flying with it. I'm traveling with it. It's what it's gonna be, you know. And it turned out he was all right, you know. But the fact that when they see them, and I have to see that fear and that hurt in their face, man, it's like, I don't know, man. It break my heart. You know what I'm saying? Like, I could teach y'all, but the thing about it is, these people are human too. They got wives. They lose some of them going through stuff like we going through. They bring all that to work, man. You know, that's why I was telling people, like, you can't look at them as, they supposed to be public service, but you can't look at them like robots, man. You know, they got feelings too. They going through shit too, and on a bad day, and you tripping, you can have a bad, bad day, you know. And it's just what it is, you know. But you just have to hold your ground, bro. You know what's right, you know what's wrong. You know, tell them you need a supervisor out there. You know, if things ain't going right, you know, you need everything that you can get on that camera.
Have you been on flag since?
Yeah, I got flagged with a couple of dudes in the court and all type of stuff.
Yeah, bro. They treat you different.
Hey, you ain't been in the court, Mr. Brown. Yeah. 3 pistols. Okay. Can you step out for a second? Can I check?
Yeah, go ahead.
Right, you have a nice day. You know, I don't have that, but I know. We talk about it all the time. I'm gonna meet that asshole. And it's fucked up. I've been waiting on it. You know what I'm saying? But I know how this goes. You know what I'm saying? The name. These officers feel like I drugged their partner through the mud. You know, it's a different mentality with them. You know what I'm saying? That blue coat, you know, it just, you know, you stirring up stuff. You're supposed, after that happened, you're supposed to shut the hell up. You're supposed to let this go. You know, it's a lot of people upset with me. You know, and I know this one day. Come on, bro. I done heard it all over them, all everything, bro. I done heard it. You know, but
that's the shit people don't know.
It's crazy.
Move on from your pain. You got
life. It's crazy. It's crazy.
Same thing I said.
I could read y'all a book on her. It's crazy. But, you know, you just got to keep pushing, bro. You know, I just want to just be a great example for them kids, man. Look out for these fathers, these families. You know, I can sit up all day and talk about what I'm going through. mentally with the situation. But as long as I leave a legacy of what I'm doing now and keeping his name alive, bro, that's what it's all about with me. You know?
That's what's up. Like I said, I remember shit. Like I said, he went to Norman. He played football up there. Mm-hmm. And after, I still remember seeing the pitch when he had a big jerseys on. Like, that was our freshman jerseys. I said, who ain't had them in the nasty, but our freshman joints. And yeah. I said, damn. I said, I got partners that shit. I still talk to today. Graduated with him, legit played with him, and everything up. My nigga Tion, J. Lou, all of them. Mm-hmm. They running backs up there. They yeah. dogs. I'm like, shit. You never heard nothing bad about him. Like, everything you hear about him straight. Man, shit, gentle giant, cool. Like I say, you over there in the hood, it's like, you know, shit just, man, seeing some shit like that happen, especially, like I said, to an alumni, to a brother, like I say, from the hood, from everything, like that shit different, like, because, like I said, we see shit
on TV. Yeah. School shit.
Thinking stuff like that could happen.
Like, damn, that's crazy.
In St. Louis, like, damn, yeah. We just feel like, I don't want to say eventually, but it feel like if something like that happening, the niggas around the corner. Like, it's always that type of mindset. So when that happened, where it's like, shit, like I say, especially when it comes down to race, yeah, that's the killer. Yes. Like that's the difference when it comes to that situation, because it's like, man, that's some shit you see only on with us, only on movies.
Right.
Mississippi Burning, that type of energy right there. Like, so this being St. Louis, where, yeah, that's something that yeah, hit way different.
Yeah, I went mute for a long time. You gonna have to say something. They gonna think he ain't had no daddy. Bigger than shit. About that boy didn't have no daddy, bro.
That's crazy.
You know what I'm saying? That bio picture that Leslie, which is his brother, mm-hmm. Husband had put up. He had was holding a sign at the end of camp. He killed my son and some stuff like that. They thought that was his father for a minute. But it's by me not saying it, but they telling me, you know, if you ain't gonna say nothing, that's gonna move the people or anything, you know. We think you shouldn't say nothing at all, and you know, angry faced black man, you know, on TV, you know, in front of a microphone, you know, can stir up some other things. But these tears off these mothers, you know, we think that she should do a lot of the speaking, you know, and you know, people go. People feel heartbroken, you know, when they see tears from a woman and she's speaking about her love.
So they kind of push me to the back a little bit. You know, yeah, they kind of push me to the back a little bit. But I had to catch it. But I had to catch it, though, before it got too late. You know, hey, look, check it out. Yeah, this is really how I'm feeling.
Yeah.
You know, but.
It was pushing their fatherless agenda.
Yeah,
man. That's all it was.
That's what they do.
It's perfect.
Okay. And it's okay because at the end of the day, that is his mother. So it was okay, you know, but.
But at the same time,
just didn't want to get pushed out the way, you know what I'm saying? So I had to make my entrance. Once I made my entrance, I'm still here.
That's the thing about St. Louis. So I can say St. Louis small enough where, shit, with the media doing it, niggas know who you is.
Yeah.
Like, people know, I got pilots from, like I said, Northwoods, they're like the older guys, but they know who you are. I mean, they like, you about to go over to holler at Big Mike. Mm-hmm. I should remember everything. Like, so, like, the media shit, that's some, yeah. Real world, we know, like, the truth. We know what's up. Like, that's the thing, like I say, it's fucked up because it's all political. And they come and try to tell you how to feel about this situation. That's nothing but political.
Right? Yeah.
Like, that's all it is. Tell you, look, don't show your emotion on this, in front of this. Don't talk if you ain't going to say, like, I'm hurt.
Right.
So don't tell me how to feel.
Let's talk more about your summer camp you got coming up.
So, actually, the summer camp started last week. It's the second week. We got, like, 20 kids now. Ages 5 to 14. It starts from 9 a.m. to 5. You know, a lot of families work late. You know, we do a little donation or whatever. We take a donation a little bit after those hours if you have to pick them up a little later. You know, but yeah, you know, we got arts and crafts, got kickball, softball. Soccer, we doing field trips. We just took them to that park in Bell Fountain. It's called where Ashley were.
Damn.
Fort Bell Fountain, right? So there's a lot of history there. They got a lot of billboards and stuff like that that tells the history of what happened. There's a lot of our people who has been coming in on that part, you know, in the beginning. So it just ain't went downtown. It's other parts of this of the Mississippi River. Because it's funny. It ain't funny, but you know, y'all know what I'm saying. You know, it's other parts of the Mississippi River where they were able to unload us, you know. So it has a lot of history. It has a walk part. It has buildings and stuff like that, like holdover buildings and stuff like that where I guess they did they practices or whatever they did in these buildings, man. But all this stuff is still intact, you know. So when you walk it, you can see it, you know. It tells the story right there.
It says in Bill Family?
Yes, sir. Okay. A lot of people don't know about it.
So
you got to sign. You got to sign in to get in.
We sure
sign in, and they get your plate.
No, they was talking about that part that you can't go to no more for the streaking charge.
They ain't got no streaking charge. Come
I ought to check that out though, man. It's cool.
Yeah, we should stay over there. That's the crazy thing. I've never heard of it. It's cool. Park Bell Family Park. And I know all the parts over there. That's crazy.
So if you take Bell Farm Road all the way out towards the county, you take it all the way out to its stop. That's where it's at.
Were they building new zoo and stuff at?
Well, we didn't see that. It's kind of good, but you
Bell Family Road.
So you take it all the way out.
Like big houses all at the end, past Redman.
Keep going.
Had a party there last year. Swim.
Keep going. Mm-hmm. Once you pass up, what is that? Parker. Once you pass up Parker, keep going. Take it all the way around. That
split going towards Spindle Lake Park.
Keep it all the way around. Keep going on the way around. That's why I said we got hidden jewels too in the city, man. People don't, you know. It's crazy. People come to our city, get a booklet, and know more shit than we got. And we've been living all our life and don't know nothing.
We know the same. We brought up down here, you know, the exact same spots, you know, where the mall's at.
Yeah.
The places that you quote unquote don't post it on.
To go, right?
The clubs and stuff like that. Yeah. I tell people, man, look, I love St. Louis. Like, you just got to travel. Yeah. Travel, experience more things. And, hey, St. Louis is not a bad place.
So it's being held at Harold J. Port. It's off Jamestown, Old Jamestown Mall. I mean, Old Jamestown Road, sort of, in Blackjack. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we got a registration. We got stuff that people want to can look at and see, you know, because some of these kids are coming from out of the summer school. So they come in half a day, but a lot of them are coming. They getting there like 7 o'clock in the morning.
You know? The age range.
So the age range is 5 to 14. So yeah, I got to cut people on staff, man. So we got them all split up. So you know, they get breakfast, they get lunch, they get a snack. You know, so and with the little payment that it costs, you know, the field trips, the food, everything is included. Got to worry about your kid, you know. Just drop them off, keep them moving.
Go about your day. Missing
money. Right. Well, 180 a week. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. How old?
Four. He a grown man, though.
Look at himself.
I'm telling you, a grown man.
Watch yourself.
$50 a week. Hey, look, we're going to have a conversation because man, I'm putting my head buzzed. Now, tell the people where they can find you at all platforms.
Yes. Just slow. I ain't bring my glass, man. My reading glass. So you can find us on chosenforchange.org. You can find us on Facebook, the Michael Brown Chosen for Change organization. What is Twitter? Twitter is
at
MBSenior.org.
At
Chosen Change of Instagram. See, she run all my pages, man. I don't, you know, but I gotta learn it though, you know.
That's what
we've
been
trying. Yeah. Yeah. So there's a couple of platforms, but yeah, I our biggest thing, you know, where you can find us is the thechosenchange.org. You can see everything that we've been doing over the years. You can donate.
And if you had to say anything, like I say, to any parent, anybody in the city, anybody, period, any black man, black woman out here, what would you tell them? Is anything positive, just to stay driving, just to keep going, what would you tell them?
But definitely, I tell them, I appreciate the city, man, standing up for what they believe in. You know, they knew that what happened in 2014 was wrong. You know, our foundation is here and built over for the people. So if you need us to step up, come pop up, you know, words of encouragement. Need me to come and talk to you, even your child, your daughter, you know, I can do that. I can make myself available for that, you know. But overall, look for the sky. Look to the sky. You know, keep it moving. Keep it pushing. I know it's hard out here. Everybody's dealing with something, you know. Keep God first, man. Keep it moving.
Let me see, because I'm trying to figure out a way to age you. Like, but you can point out three traits about your son that nobody knew, like I say, but to you, your wife, your baby mom, like his mother, like other siblings. Three just traits that just separated him from anybody else.
Oh, man. Shit. He had a crazy laugh. This dude, he smoked. But he can sit up and have a conversation with you, man. Blow smoke out of his mouth without smoking. It's crazy. You know, how you do that? You know what I'm saying? Just blow smoke out of his mouth, man. I'm like, damn, how the fuck he do that? But he was a jokester, man. He was funny, man. He liked girls, man. You know what I'm saying? He did his own thing, man. He was trying to find his way, bro. But overall, man, I miss him. I love him. I'm gonna ride it all the way out to my casket drop, boy. You already know this. You know?
That's enough said. I know what it is, man. I'm gonna say thank you.
Thanks, y'all, love. I appreciate y'all having me, man.
You took his life, but your memory is never
changed.
You'll be headed to another place, and the life you used to live will reflect in your mother's face. I still gotta wonder why I never seen a man cry till I seen a man die.